Broadcasting from Skyline High School World Headquarters, it's time for SPTV News.
What up, Skyline? Skyline, what's up? I'm Dax Kringle. I'm alongside the one and only Tony Evzich.
What's up, Skyline? And we're your new news anchors for the winter shows.
Hey, Spartans, make sure you come on down to the Lower Commons on Friday, December 16th, for Hope the Holidays and Relay for Life benefit concert. Tickets are $7 for students and $9 for adults, and all proceeds go towards Relay for Life. There will also be treats for sale at the event, an amazing live performance, so make sure you don't miss out. And Skyline, next week kicks off Winter Wonder Week, and I'm more than excited for the Spirit Days. Tony, what we got for the Spirit Days?
All right, Dax. Monday is Candy Cane Day. That one's for Canis Hunter. Tuesday is Twinkly Lights Day. Wednesday is Winter Wear Day, so wear your winter gear. Thursday is Ugly Sweater Day, so Dax, just wear what you normally wear to school, and you're good. Friday is Snow Day, so wear your white, and then follow that up on Monday, there's another Pajama Day, followed by the last day of school before break, being happy for the holiday season.
What a wonderful week. Well, let's kick it to Emily Tang and get a scoop of the news.
Hi, I'm Emily Tang with your world news in 30 seconds. An 18-year-old student at Ohio State University attacked other students on campus with a butcher knife. Before the attack, he had posted on Facebook about his frustration with the mistreatment of Muslims in America. The student was shot after disobeying orders to stop. A charter plane crashed in Colombia, killing 71 passengers, including members of a Brazilian soccer team. Last Wednesday, supporters of the team mourned the lost victims during a tribute at the team stadium in Brazil. A Tacoma police officer was killed while responding to a domestic violence call. He was shot by a suspect using two young children as human shields. The suspect is now deceased, and the children were taken to the hospital as a precaution. I'm Emily Tang, and this has been Around the World in 30 seconds.
Thanks, Emily. What a world we live in.
Yeah, what a world, Tony. We all know I'm a gamer, and I could beat you in, like, every video game.
Dax, I've told you before, Club Penguin does not count as a video game, nor do I care that you play it. But in this week's Spartan Spotlight, I think we've got someone who could be us all.
Albert Chang is a sophomore at Skyline High School that has recently been accepted to play in Sweden for CSGO on Team USA. Olivia and I checked in with him on how he has been handling it so far.
The game I currently specialize in is Counter-Strike Global Offensive. Well, I got this opportunity by going to a local event called PAX.
PAX is a convention made for games. They focus on the culture and community that is gaming. PAX 2016 was held on September 2nd to the 5th.
When I first got to PAX, I saw this massive Aces booth, and it had Counter-Strike on the front. And I was just like, this is like the first time I've ever seen Counter-Strike at one of these events. So I got really excited. And this guy who was managing the booth came up to me and was like, hey, you seem like you're a pretty good Counter-Strike player. Why don't you just try playing in 1v1 against a professional, and you might get sponsorship and to compete in Sweden. And these Swedish film crew right next to the booth. And so they said that I should come back to the finals audition in about like a few hours and get ready to go against the other finalists. 30 minutes after the finals audition, all suspense was gone. Eric Flom started to talk to us about the finalists. He basically looked straight into my eyes, said this. Now, some players didn't get in. Sadly, I have to kick them out. But these players are on a team, and my name came out first. So he started talking to me, and he started pulling me over, saying, dude, you got in. And I was like, oh, really? And then I got an awesome boot camp trip to Las Vegas. This Vegas trip was actually to help promote their laptops, or hashtag mobile gaming. And we basically got these free gaming laptops with some gear, went out to Mojave Desert, and just started filming some promotion videos for Aces. The experience was absolutely amazing. I got to hang out with one of probably the most popular Twitch CSGO streamers. And we got to get personal, we got to talk about each other's lives. We get to just hang out, and it was an amazing trip. The final competition will be held in Stockholm, Sweden, and that will go around January 2nd is when I head out, and I'll come back around January 8th. We're pretty excited, and we're getting our practicing really hard to just be ready for that and probably win the grand finals, but we don't know what a grand prize is, so that's really keeping us on our edge of our seats.
Albert continues to practice and train for his upcoming trip to Sweden. We wish you luck, Albert, and back to you, Tony and Dax.
Well, look what's back, Dax. Much like that girl, this segment is a real crowd pleaser. It's Upper Left USA. Let's see where we're going today.
Hey Skyline, I'm Olivia Schlossstein, and welcome back to another episode of Upper Left USA, where I show you cool things to do around the Pacific Northwest. For this week's episode, I'm bringing you to Odd Fellows Cafe, one of my favorite cafes in Capitol Hill. That's about it, so let's get into the video.
That place looks awesome. I might have to go check that out.
Everyone, make sure you pre-order your Strong for Sam shirts for the Stinky Sneaker. You can pre-order until Friday at both lunches on the stage for just $10.
All right, we're new news anchors, so that means there must be a new sports anchor. So let's head over to Olivia Deuces for sports.
Sports!
Hey Spartans, I'm Olivia Dosties, your new sports anchor. The winter sports season is officially up and running, so let's dive right into it. Boys Swim and Dive had their first meet last Thursday where they beat Issaquah 96-80. Way to go, boys. Make sure to head down to Bone Pool tomorrow and show some support as they take on East Lake. Last Tuesday, the boys basketball team beat Liberty 70-65. Four players scored in double digits and were led by Ashish Manda. Last Friday, they lost to Shorecrest 58-67. Last night, the boys took on Bothell, and we'll have a full recap next week. Girls basketball beat Coeur d'Alene on Friday 70-50. The girls were down at half, but came together in the end to take the lead. Nice job, girls. Last night, they also played Bothell, and we'll have a full recap next week. Sadly, gymnastics lost last Thursday to Woodinville, 138-169. The girls fought hard and even had four people placed in the top 10 for the all-around. Way to go, girls. Their next meet is tomorrow against Mount Si. Saturday was a big day for many Skyline athletes. Wrestling competed in the Clash of Classes tournament. The boys went 4-0 this weekend, beating Lake Washington, Liberty, Juanita, and Mercer Island. Their next meet is tomorrow at home against Bothell, so make sure to come out and show some Skyline spirit. The dance team headed down to the Hazen Regional Dance Competition, where they took first in kicks and in dance. Congrats, girls. Way to make Skyline proud. Cheer also competed this past Saturday in the Pride of Palooza Exhibition Competition. Way to make Skyline proud. Lastly, congrats to the following athletes for making the Seattle Times All-Area Team. Henry Bonvalu, Alex Deagle, Bradley Kim, and Anna Smith. That's it for this week, Spartans. Back to you, Tony and Dax.
Great job, Spartans. Keep up the hard work. And a very happy birthday to Coach Hyland
and McGordy.
Well, that wraps up news this week, Spartans. I'm Tony.
And I'm Dax. See you next time, Skyline.
Hey Skyline, I'm Zahara from Spanish Club, and this year we're doing a project called the Pulsera Project.
So pulseras are bracelets and they're handmade in Nicaragua, and so this year you can buy one for $5 and it will benefit bringing education to children in Nicaragua. So look for us at A Lunch or B Lunch on the 15th and 16th to get your own pulsera. They work as great Christmas or holiday gifts.
Each pulsera is like specifically made by a special artist in Nicaragua, and each one has, when you buy it, look for the tag that has the artist's name on it, and 100% of the proceeds go directly to benefiting children and to build orphanages and schools in Nicaragua. Thank you.